Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video again we are going to discuss about a new project topic that will be very much helpful in your final year project. So we will be discussing a new topic, and if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click on the subscribe button so that you get important updates whenever a new video is uploaded on the channel. And also, it's very important if you are working on a project and if you need any assistance or if you need any type of help, or so you can just comment me and you can just let me know your project topic, and I can guide you on the type of technology that you can use, how you can, which if you are making a web application, which server you can use to upload, what are the free server options and how you can use that those free server options so that you can show your project to your guide. So let us start the video. First thing, in this particular video we are going to discuss about the online project in which like you can also create a web application plus an app also. So it will be basically a combination of web application and mobile app. So the topic is text to speech. So in this case, basically right now this concept is very much used and it is used in almost every project, and this is very very new because you can implement this in both web and mobile. So basically we can record different types of files like PDF files and PowerPoint presentation to speech automatically. So you have seen that most of the time, like if somebody wants to read a particular text, so the text to speech, what it will be doing, basically it is an API that you can call in your Android app or iOS app or in your web application. So instead of having everything on your server, what you can do, you can have a API implementation. So it will be used for children. So if they want to learn how to do pronunciation or how to spell a word, so there will be three different modules. Like you can go for kids, so they can learn how to pronounce a word. For other people, this text to speech API will be very helpful because they, instead of reading everything by themselves, this text to speech, it will read the full PowerPoint for them. There will be some modules that will allow them to adjust the speed through which they are reading the particular document. Plus you can also use this API in your Android app. So in Android app, if you have a search, so instead of like using this search manually, you can use audio, and that will be used to search from different files. So main concept will be in implementing this particular concept in reading a document, and that, like you can see, text to speech makes an Android device read the text and convert it into audio via the speaker. Android TTS is text to speech supports multiple languages, so it's not like it's only English or Hindi, it can be done for different languages, so you can make your app multilingual. Plus, text to speech is a simple but powerful feature. It can also be effectively used in mobile apps, as I told you that it is for mobile apps and also for visually impaired people. So this particular idea is very good for visually impaired people, where they are not able to see anything. So for them, this will be very good thing because it will allow them to listen what is there on a particular file or a particular document, and they can use that in order to learn new things. Also, it can be used for educational apps for kids, for pronunciation of learning app. These are some of the ways you can use this text to speech, and it is a very good option whenever you want to increase the interaction of your app with the user. So this is quite a very good idea, and as I told you that you can create both for Android app and web application. And this Android app you can just upload on the Google App Store, and then you can show to your guide all the features that are implemented using the text to speech. So friends, this was a new project topic for the final year computer science students. So if you like this video for the topic text to speech conversion, please like, share and subscribe. And if you have any project, any type of project, whether it is a web application, Android app, iOS app, if you have any issue, if you want to discuss, you can just comment me and we can just discuss there, or I can share some ideas on your topic. So friends, this was the topic for today. Thank you very much. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.